and mushroom spore, tender parts a prickle bore!
You sure you want me for this?
This is awful as I remember. I'd hoped I'd never have to drink it again.
Are you all right, Eleanor?
Is this your second experience with the Corsair Scourge?
No, I had it for a different reason. In the Abbey, it's tradition for initiates to drink Solitoma as part of their welcoming festivities.
Sounds like hazing to me.
When everyone shares the same experience, drinking something so shockingly revolting, our bonds are strengthened. It's a good thing.
If you say so.
I really did believe I'd never have to taste it again. To be blunt, I hate it.
You're lucky you think it tastes so terrible. That means you also know what tastes good. Right, Velvet?
What does that mean?
Velvet can't taste anything aside from blood.
What? Is that because she's a demon?
I'm aware of one other flavor. Mogulu? Here's your dose of Solitoma.
No!
Get back here!
Don't! Keep that salad away from me! I see. The sweet taste of another suffering. Why does it seem like everyone around me is completely mad?
Yeah! Continuing to fight when you know you'll lose just is insane!
Would you stand around and watch your comrade die, just because you're scared?
I wouldn't want to, but getting myself killed wouldn't save anyone either.
Yes, it would be illogical to fight.
Is being illogical really that bad?
Well...
At the Empyrean's throne, I remember Velvet standing, despite the horrible pain she felt. Rokuro is training with all his heart in order to defeat his brother Shigure. And Kurogane used up his own head to forge a powerful blade.
None of that is very logical.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to put it, but I think it's all amazing.
Aren't you forgetting someone?
Mogilu is traveling with us. Even though she doesn't care. And that...
Yes? Go on.
I don't really understand what that's about.
Miss Mogulu, hang in there!
Well, it is amazing in some sense, I suppose.
Hello there. You're headed to Loringan Tower, too? Just a bit ago, a brawny, silver-haired man asked me how to get there.
Did he say why he was going there?
Something about meeting some friends of his. Exorcists use that tower to train, right? If he has exorcist friends, then maybe he's one, too. But he seemed a bit rough and tumble to be an exorcist. I can't imagine a man like him.
Did he say anything else?
He said someone else might stop by and ask about the tower, and told me to tell him if they do. Did he mean you?
No clue.
So he was planning on us following him. What's he scheming?
You mean Zavid? Or the Abbey?
Both.
Loringan Tower lies beyond the Burnak Plateau.
Blah! If you're gonna set up an obvious trap, couldn't it at least be someplace more convenient?
What's wrong, Lafayette?
I was just wondering why Aizen and Zavid can't work together to find Ifrid. All men their age care about is their reputation, their street cred. Such a hassle.
Oh, really?
Well, I can't fully deny it.
The same could be said of women, and of everyone, really. It's hard to work alongside someone unless you strive to understand their thoughts and feelings.
And if you can't?
Well,
It's like Zavid said, you start talking with your fists instead.
Sounds harder than I thought.
Let's get started!
Get away!
Get over there!
have a peculiar air about you.
Yeah, I don't think you're one of them.
You better be ready.
Hey, is everyone all right?
Those rainbows.
This is one of the seven wonders of the world, the Bernac Geyser. The water heats up from underground until the pressure forces it to spray up from the surface.
And the rainbows are caused by light reflecting from the salt suspended in the mineral water. It took tens of thousands of years for the minerals to accumulate here and form this phenomenon.
Wowee!
That was very educational.
At least you know plenty of trivia, if nothing else.
Additionally, the groundwater veins that feed this geyser are connected to the sea. Because of this, every now and then a boiled octopus or crab will shoot out from the geyser!
No way!
That's impossible. Well, not impossible, but...
With the salt content of the geyser's water, I bet they're seasoned to perfection.
Mogulu, I'm declaring your bizarre imagination the eighth wonder of the world.
People say that all the time.
You better be ready.
Don't touch it. You'll hurt yourself.
In other words, the rest of her is fair game.
Not unless you really want to get hurt.
Did you get the medicine to the ship's crew?
Yeah.
Good. My thanks to you.
These soldiers won't be happy in the morning, but they're alive. Is this your work?
No. They were like this when I got here. It must have been Zavid.
He didn't kill a single one. Interesting.
The Abbey is going to great lengths to arrest him.
Even so, he clearly knows he's walking into a trap. What I don't get is why he roped me into all of this. If he didn't want my help, then what need did he have to play the Ifrig card on me?
If you knew this was a trap, why did you come?
To see for myself. When I met Ifrig, I was wallowing in despair that I would ever find a way to break the Reaper's curse. Stop denying reality, he told me. If you were really born with that curse, then it's a part of you. But if the Reaper learns to grasp the wheel of his life, even he may find his creed, his path through stormy waters. And so, I joined him aboard the Von Eltia.
A creed of life.
Let's say someone's murdered the captain. If it came as the result of him living life on his terms, I could accept that. But if anyone, and I mean anyone, tries to crush his way of life, I could never forgive them.
Who's there?
It's rude to eavesdrop.
If you got secrets, talk about them at home.
Zavid, isn't there any way you and Aizen can work together somehow?
Not if he's going to keep acting like this. Well, that's how it is.
What was the point of all that posturing? He could have just stayed hidden. Weirdo.
Can't disagree there.
Loringen Tower is a training ground for exorcists, right?
Yes. It's a great edifice built on ancient ruins.
Lafayette, did you ever go there when you were tethered to Teresa?
I don't really remember the beginning of my service to Teresa.
I see.
What sort of training do they do there?
Exorcists are tested and assigned malakim equivalent to their aptitude with mana. It's also where they practice malak arts and study our laws.
So the lower ranks use it as a sparring ground in order to train up to the higher ranks?
No, an exorcist's affinity to mana is not something that strengthens through training. We are given malakim based on our inborn ability, then learn arts to suit that ability.
So, an orderly is an orderly for life, then?
Correct.
There'd be no spirit of competition, then. Don't they want to get stronger, to advance through the ranks?
There'd be no purpose to advancement. Rank signifies nothing more than the type and number of malakim one can tether. People join the Abbey for only two reasons. To protect people from demons, and to save the world.
Are all of you that dedicated to asceticism?
How sickeningly noble of you.
I wonder if your wills are suppressed just like those of the malakim you use.
Deviants like you could never possibly understand our motives. In any case, that is who awaits you at Loringen Tower.
So we're in for a rough welcome. I say bring it on. I can't wrap my head around Zavid.
We witnessed his unwillingness to kill before, but it seems he's quite serious about it.
Maybe that's why I don't feel scared of him. Even when he and Aizen were about to fight, I didn't feel tense at all.
Perhaps that's just because you've been around Velvet a bit too long, kiddo. Next to her, few people are frightening.
Do you think so?
Don't ask me.
He doesn't come across as vicious. I think that's why you're not scared.
Because he's just a brawler?
Maybe he's just naive.
Okay, so he's just a naive brawler. He's still involved with Ifrig's disappearance, and he's also taking on the Abbey. I just don't get him.
Me neither.
Uh-huh.
I agree, but I don't understand any of you either.
You want me in? Fine by me.
I don't get it.
Get what?
Why did Eifried let Aizen join his ship, knowing he carried the Reaper's curse with him? What good did it do? I just don't see the reason behind it.
Well, if it were me who had that curse, it would mean that you and Velvet could die because of it, right?
Yeah, I suppose so.
If that's the case, then I'd feel like I'd both want to and not want to be close to you two. And I'd probably really, really hate myself for it.
Do you suppose that's how Aizen feels? But Eifried still took him in. He agreed they put up with the curse together.
It's all a bit hard to fathom.
Well, if one thing's for certain, it sounds like Eifried's a very strong man. At least for a base lawless pirate.
Aizen, can I ask you about that thing Zavid had?
It belonged to Eifried, didn't it? I've read much of the Abbey's archives on weaponry, but I've never seen anything like it.
He found it when we crossed to the far continent. It's a relic from a long-vanished civilization. He's like me and can't resist a good treasure. But of everything we've found, that one was his most prized.
What is it?
I can't say. It seemed like a weapon, but Eifried wouldn't let anyone touch it. He went off and tested it on his own, then came back all grinning, saying he had an ace up his sleeve the next time we got into a fight.
Then it's definitely some sort of ancient combat device? But why is Zavid looking for Eifried? To apologize for stealing it?
He doesn't seem like that much of a gentleman.
Did he really steal it?
What do you mean?
It's just my feeling, but Zavid doesn't seem like the type of Moloch to steal something so precious.
He said he just picked it up. Perhaps he's trying to return it.
Perhaps. Take a look at this.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Scout ship set.
See this?
Here's upon my firing heels!
that I'm this close.
I won't miss! Form zero!
Unarmed? Hardly. These are deadly weapons.
What'll it take to make you
bothering to hide this trap.
They probably knew we'd sense it. The question now is just what they're planning to spring on us.